On 22nd May 2010, a man in Florida paid $10,000 for two pizzas. We all had a laugh and that guy had a full stomach. In 2010, those 10,000 bitcoins were worth less than half a cent. Oi, lagbag 0.01509496 rupees. Two pizza ke liye. 11 years on, 10,000 bitcoins are worth more than now. Get this. $350 million. What just happened? What most people thought was just a weird online fad has now developed into nearly 11,000 different cryptocurrencies in 2021. In fact, crypto tycoons have even made it to the Forbes billionaire list. This virtual coin is now beginning to look very real. So if you feel crypto FOMO, then you're in the right place. Welcome to On The Money and I'm here to let you in the crypto club. Okay, so if you've made it this far into the video, you're still like, yeah, what is crypto exactly? I mean, if it's a digital currency, ye net banking se kaise lage? Let me break it down for you. You see, the paper money that we use, it's issued by the government. The digital money that we use to make online transactions, that is just electronic form of paper money. All of this currency is regulated by the Reserve Bank of India. The main difference between electronic version of regular money and crypto is very simple. Cryptocurrencies are not issued or regulated by a central body like a bank. Let me explain it to you like a 5-year-old. You and your friends are hanging out. He has 3 coins, you have 0 coins. Your friend gives you 1 coin. Okay? Now, you didn't need a third party to regulate this coin transaction, this coin handover. It was just coin, hand, done. There was no bank in the middle regulating this transaction, and you were able to handle this transaction just between the two of you. Now, this coin was physically passed from their hand to your hand. So, you have a proof of transaction. I mean, you saw it. You felt it. But to pass a digital coin from one person to another would be difficult without having some sort of proof of transaction. What if you could pass a digital currency from one party to another without the necessity of a third party? And all of this in a complete proof of transaction available to see for everyone. So a white paper called Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash, was published in 2008, which outlined a system that allowed online payments to be sent directly from one party to another without relying on a financial institution. And this paper became the basis of the entire cryptocurrency institution we see today. The paper was published by a mysterious entity called Satoshi Nakamoto. This name is actually a pseudonym for the person or persons who developed Bitcoin, wrote the paper, and created the system to implement Bitcoin, the original cryptocurrency. It's a long paper, so let me just give you a TLDR. By the way, till today, nobody really knows who Satoshi Nakamoto is. Many people have claimed to be him, but nobody really knows. Pretty badass. Okay, chalo, back to it. With a digital coin, one can argue that several copies can be made and therefore that one same coin can be spent more than once. Is it kehte hain the double spending problem? So, how do we stop double spending? By using a network known as blockchain. Because har cryptocurrency ke paas na ek khud ka network hota hai, jisme system records transactional information and is impossible to manipulate. Let's talk about why it's impossible to manipulate. But first, hame ek apni currency chahiye hogi. Let's call it a wish coin. Because fun fact, anyone can build their own cryptocurrency. Now that we have a currency, we'll build a network around it. And within this network, let's say Siddharth, okay? Siddharth has 10 wish coins. So the block will show the amount of coins he has and a hash, which is basically an encrypted code against each transaction. The hash changes with every transaction. Let's see how. Now, Siddharth sends Jatin 3 wish coins. A second block appears with this transaction. It shows that 3 wish coins have been deducted. Along with this transaction, a new hash is generated and the previous hash is still visible. So now, every time a transaction is initiated, a new block representing that transaction is created. This block will have the details of the transaction that outline who's paying whom and what amount. The new block with the transaction detail is sent to everyone's computer in the blockchain. A blockchain which is essentially a digital ledger and every person in the network has access to the same. A request is made on the network to verify and confirm if the 3 wish coins that Siddharth transacted actually belong to him. For this, members of the network check the hash and solve an arbitrary mathematical puzzle to verify the transaction. This is called proof of work, and each person that verifies the transaction is offered a small reward for this. These people are called crypto miners. And since anyone in the system can be a miner, that's M-I-N-E-R by the way, bachcho ko crypto pocket money nahi milti hai. So, just because cryptocurrency is unregulated, it does not mean that the transactions are not secure. But the next question that comes up is that, what if like me, you have zero coding skills? Can you still own cryptocurrency? The short answer is yes. You can buy any cryptocurrency that you want and even trade it on crypto exchanges like Unocoin, WazirX, ZebPay, CoinDCX, and CoinSwitch Kube. And that's not all. Today, in some countries around the world, you can book flights, car rentals, and hotels with travel agents or buy NFTs like digital artwork or domain name, in-game items, and even memes. Speaking of memes, let's get into Dogecoin. Dogecoin is a joke that escalated rather slowly. It was created back in 2013 by software engineers who just really enjoyed Doge, the Shiba Inu meme dog. The intention was to take a dig at investors who invest in assets mindlessly, which ironically 8 years later, to be really honest, can be seen right now in the market on several occasions. A Puerto Rican technology company, Bots Inc., is actually making Dogecoin a payment option for buying pre-owned Teslas. And speaking of Teslas, what has Elon Musk got to do with any of this? Well, apart from being a long-time supporter of cryptocurrencies and calling Dogecoin a hustle on SNL, he's shooting for the moon by 2024 in his fancy new futuristic spaceship. Speaking of the future, what's the scene with cryptocurrency's future in India? Well, this year, Indian government surprised quite a lot of people and announced its plan to introduce a bill to create a sovereign digital currency. In fact, India is already among top 5 countries where people own cryptocurrencies. According to various reports, around 15 million Indians are said to have invested in cryptocurrencies. Although the price of a single Bitcoin today is inflated to around $50,000, that's a long way from half a cent for 10,000 Bitcoins. In late April 2021, the crypto market crashed, bringing down the value of most cryptocurrencies. A number of Nobel Prize-winning economists have warned against it, saying that it's a speculative bubble and that its value should be zero. Since it's an asset without any intrinsic value, a hard crash is possible again. And although many governments are on board, there is no official way of regulating cryptocurrency. But others feel that it might lead to a new form of decentralized economy. There is also debate around whether crypto can hedge inflation, since the number of coins available are finite. I mean, for example, there are only 1,000 coins in the world, which makes the pool of currency finite, as opposed to being able to print more money as and when needed. Inflation will not factor in. But others say that cryptocurrency's history in this world is too short to tell that if it will be impactful against rising prices. What's going to happen to cryptocurrency? Well, that's really not clear. Whether it'll change the future or crash, that remains to be seen. But one thing in the future is for sure, that we will be coming back with yet another informative new episode of On The Money. In the meanwhile, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to Cred's YouTube channel, and thank you for watching this video.